The nurse we lost on Saturday was 33 years old. He was the nurse covering at night the previous week, and then around Monday last week he started feeling unwell, and he called in sick. He didn't come to work. Later on he went to a facility in Nairobi where he was started on treatment, but the following day he called the nursing manager and informed her that he was not feeling well. And at that time then we sent an ambulance from Kangundo Level 4 Hospital to go and pick him from his Nairobi home, and he was brought here to Machakos Level 5 where we tested him, and we found him to be COVID-19 positive, and we put him on isolation and started managing him well. We continued managing him until on Saturday morning when his family requested that he be transferred to Kenyatta University Teaching and Research Hospital in Nairobi. And he was referred there, but a few hours after he was admitted at KU Hospital, he passed on. And therefore, I want to say that there is no patient in our hospitals who has lacked oxygen. As I've said, that our colleague, the nurse, is the family who requested that he be transferred to Nairobi. What I'm saying is, as Machakos County, we've had very many patients coming from neighboring counties, including more than 50% of the patients in our COVID-19 ICU are from outside Machakos County. And because of that, the demand for consumables has been high. Our duty is to ensure that there is continuous replenishment. And that's what we are doing. At no given time would we wish to expose any of our healthcare workers to risk. And I remind my healthcare workers that they have a duty to protect themselves. No healthcare worker should work without the proper personal protective equipment. But as a department, as a government, it's our duty to ensure that we provide the personal protective equipment to all our healthcare workers. Yes.